What do you think the next 1,000 years of this world are going to look like?
1,000 years of this world.
Okay, I get that that's a long time to think about. But this video is all about thinking incredibly long term in the book, The Clock of Long Now, and the concepts behind it. Let's get into it in today's video. Now, contrary to how we think so often in school or just in life in general, the book, The Clock of Long Now, and the concept behind the Clock of the Long Now Foundation, which is actually a society about structuring and bringing out the longevity in our thinking about time, is all about thinking long term. How do the ramifications of what you did today impact the next 100,000 years, 10,000 years, 1,000 years, even 100 years? These are a lot bigger than our lifespan, but they're things that we have to realize, because just like with the environment, there's all these different things that when we don't pay attention to them, they can have huge ramifications for years to come. So how often do you think about the long term? How often do you think about 100 years, 10 years away from where you are now, 1,000 years? And no, not in the anxiety filled, where am I gonna be, what am I gonna be doing, am I a failure type thing, but more in the mind state of thinking incredibly long term. I wanna give you the story about Göbekli Tepe. Göbekli Tepe is a civilization found recently that actually was created around 12,000 years ago, and they filled it in. They preserved it. They preserved the cave paintings. They preserved all this stuff for us to find at some later date. Now, it is just like Stonehenge, and we didn't find it until just today. 12,000 years went by. They filled it in by hand or whatever machinery, if they had something else, remember to question everything, back then that they could have used. And they had all these sculptures that are very high with different astrological signs in them from 12,000 years ago. That's incredibly long-term thinking. That's what this whole book is about. It's about thinking for the long term. How do the things that you do now affect a lot later? Because everything you do, whether it's for your generation, it's only for your family in the long term, will have ramifications for people later in time. So that's just something to think about. I don't want to stress you out with it, but it's a thought process that we all need to explore, because since time and the management of time and the holding of time is such a high leverage skill, the ability to see how what you use your time on and the tasks and productivity you do and just about everything that you do day after day, how it adds up over the long term and how it feeds down into your kids, how it feeds down into the people that you meet all around you, how your thoughts affect those people, and how everything together creates the future is something that we all need to think about. Because if we don't think about it, it's something that can come back to bite us in the ass. At some point in time, if you don't think about what you're doing now, a long time later, it can come and make the world a lot different place. Now, this is all about time management. It's about picking the tasks that really mean something, and it's about doing them day after day. And I know I recently just filmed a video on Pomodoros and focus blocks in order to really help make sure that you can use your time efficiently and set your weeks up around big, major, good tasks. You know, I use the productivity planner day after day to make sure that I'm doing the highest and best thing for me. But what it ultimately comes down to is, what is the best thing that you're doing now that is the best for society? What can it evolve to? And is what you're doing now a dead end? If you're passionate about it, even if it's a dead end and you're following your bliss, likely it's going to be a learning lesson or something that is good for the future. Remember, life strips away layers of the onion, and you'll find more and more where your roots are. You'll be able to find your roots. And once you find your roots, you'll know exactly what you need to do next. I want to thank you for watching this video. If it helped intrigue you, gave you any thoughts, or if you're thinking about something super long-term into the future, put it in the comments below, give this video a like, and make sure to subscribe if you want to see more content like this. I want to thank you for watching once again, and I will see you in a video in the short future.